Greetings for the Oathlings, welcome back to Delta Force. Today's mission at hand is Operation Juggernaut, which is basically an ambush mission. There'll be a convoy that we need to stop. I do not think we ever engaged in an ambush mission in Indonesia. None that I can remember, at least. So yeah, it's been a while. I think the last ambush mission that we had was in Chad. So yeah, let's go ahead and see what this mission is all about. Enemy armoured column, apparently. It's got like five objectives, enemy objectives right here. And I don't know why it was set here, because it's like the objectives were completely out of screen, out of the, you know, viewport rather. And yeah, I suppose this is a better way of looking at things. I think this seems far better. So yeah, it's like a pretty standard ambush route. I think number 7 here is where we will be intercepting the convoy, or rather maybe point number 6 here, who knows. Mission: ambush and destroy an enemy armored column that is reported to be in the vicinity of Usse. I don't know how you pronounce that. I have zero clue whatsoever, because that name sort of sounds made up, but then again it probably is an actual name. So if anybody knows, let me know down in the comments how you pronounce it. Execution: your insertion points is approximately 350 meters from your convoy ambush point. Okay, so I suppose, yeah, we probably are ambushing the convoy at point number 6. Proceed north, staying close to the west cliff face. You must destroy all vehicles in the convoy before they reach their helicopter escort point in order for this mission to be a success. If any vehicle in the convoy reaches the helicopter escort point, this mission will be a failure. Roger that. Expected enemy forces. Air photographic reconnaissance shows that the area in which the convoy is traveling is heavily patrolled. The intelligence summary noted that several mercenary Spetsnaz reconnaissance scouts have enlisted with the rebel forces. The enemy convoy is believed to be composed of 2 APCs, 1 RAM scout vehicle, and 2 troop transport vehicles. Oh no, I wonder if troops actually come out of the troop transport vehicle, because that would be a lot of enemies, wouldn't it? And it already says that the region is heavily patrolled. So yeah, that sounds like it's going to be a pretty difficult mission. Looks like we're in for a ride, who knows. Allied support: Alpha team will be inserted into the hills northwest of your drop zone. They will proceed due south approximately 200 meters. They will reach the road approximately 450 meters west of Bravo team's anticipated convoy intercept point. Alpha team will then proceed east along the road, meeting you at the convoy ambush point. Bravo team is authorized 2 artillery missions and... 2 artillery missions. Oh, we can finally use the laser designator now! Yay! And it's at priority call with Whiskey 1. So I think we can finally use the laser designator at this point. That is amazing. That is amazing. Situation: numerous enemy troop convoys have been observed moving through the valley near Usse. The current method of operation for these convoys is for them to travel with helicopter escort for as long as possible. Then they make a high-speed dash across the area from where their air coverage doesn't reach to the next point where air coverage is available. I see, so time is of the essence here, or so I would suppose. With Allied air sometimes sorties committed to operations elsewhere, it is up to the ground forces in the area to intercept and destroy these convoys. Offensive operations against the convoys have been planned to catch them without air coverage. I see. Yeah, I was thinking of taking this weapon, because it would be great against enemies that are clustered together, since in this mission I'm expecting, at least at the convoy itself, I don't know about enemies before that, but at the convoy there are probably a lot of enemies clustered right next to each other. This grenade launcher is probably the best option we have right now. Now, one thing that I want to change here is probably the double load ammo. I want to change it into the LAW, light anti-tank weapon, right here. It's written right here. So I think this would be a better weapon, but if I start running out of ammo, I will retry the mission with the double load ammo. So for now, let's go ahead and see what this mission is about. Uh, Attempt number 7, I do believe, or maybe it is number 8, who knows.
Move out, Bravo, move out!
Already on it, sir. Huh. They used to run the previous time round. What? I wonder what made this guy actually stand and take a fight this time. But yeah, what I'm struggling with the most in this mission is the section up ahead, because there are so many oafs right here. So many of these oafs that it's super difficult to actually achieve anything. That guy's dead, amazingly. I didn't expect that guy to die that soon, but he did anyway. That guy's dead. I'm getting lucky with my shots right now. Cannot see anybody else over there, for now at least. Ah, there you are. You're dead. And are you alive? No, you're dead as well. You will be soon. Now you need to proceed very cautiously in this area, because the slightest bit of hurrying can actually spell disaster for you. Now the problem is, biggest problem rather, is that you cannot see any of the enemies.
Alpha to Bravo, vehicles are moving.
Roger Alpha. Now by this time, in the previous mission, Alpha had already been wiped out. And yeah, I don't know where Alpha is and how they keep getting wiped out, because I literally cannot see anybody over here in this entire section of the map who would try to actually mount an offensive against Alpha. I think that is also an enemy. Maybe they were the people who were shooting me all this while. Killing me, I mean. Is there like a Coriolis effect thing? Oh no, my crosshairs is just off. Finally that guy's dead. And yeah, the enemy, oh, that is Alpha, okay, fine, cool. Any more enemies over here? Yes, there are. There's like an entire chock full of enemies right here. I just need to be cautious with my approach, because otherwise I stand to lose a lot. And by a lot, I mean I stand to lose a lot of time. Now this is just not a good area to be pretty much doing anything, to be honest. That guy's dead as well. There is somebody else shooting at me. I think that's him. Yes. So thus far I would say I've been pretty lucky in the fact that I haven't died yet. But that wouldn't always be the case. It's pretty easy for us to die in this mission. Like, one slip up and you're dead. And that's pretty much how this mission just goes. That is a camp. Oh, I've not been far enough to see a camp before. Oh, I see an enemy. I shall engage. Now the thing is, you need to do this quickly. And I do believe I'm being a little slow at it. Because if you're not quick enough, then you could end up killing yourself. Sorry, you could end up losing the opportunity to actually engage the enemy, or rather the convoy. Because as far as I can tell, the convoy is already here. I suppose we can make a run for it now, at this point in time. Yep, I can hear the vehicles. Turn to go over and start shooting them down. Here's to hoping that I do not die while doing this. And Bravo, sorry, Alpha 1 and 2 are somewhere on top of the bush, on top of those hills. I think, yeah, there they are. And I just hope that I do not miss this convoy.
Bravo, you're closing the objective. Stay alert.
Roger, Alpha. First this one, and this one. And that is all the weapons that we have. Yes, we do have a laser designator right here.
This is King 6 requesting fire mission, over.
King 6, Whiskey 1, send your fire mission, over.
Fire mission request.
This is King 6 requesting fire mission, over.
I don't know whether I did the right thing or not by targeting that vehicle, but it did something. I mean, at least the convoy has stopped thus far. So I would say it's the beginning of something. And the good thing about using this gun is the fact that I can also use... wait, is there somebody else shooting at me? I thought I saw some bullets being fired from this direction. No? Okay. That car is dead. And so will this car be. And that is the entire
mission. Elimination confirmed. Move to extraction point for rendezvous with Black Widow.
Good job, at least we don't have to move to extraction. Now let me end this mission before I die. 21 kills, and yeah, that was difficult. That mission was a difficult one. Like, the actual mission itself wasn't as difficult as setting up in time so that you can actually go ahead and eliminate that column of enemy vehicles, which was the most difficult part. But yeah, I mean, it was a beautiful level to look at nonetheless. And I really enjoyed the sunset, the glorious sunset, and the entire skybox thing. So, yeah, excellent work, Bravo team. Your timely elimination of the enemy troop convoy before they could reach their destination has allowed US Rangers to capture a key firebase. Ah, so that was the firebase we were talking about in the previous briefing. And the ability of enemy forces to operate in this area has been effectively neutralized. That is very nice to know. With the Lake Amur area of Uzbekistan secured, we are one step closer to ending the civil war. As soon as current operations in the central and eastern portions of the country are completed, as we'll be able to make our final assault, we believe the remaining forces will be led by the rebel general who started the civil war. His personal unit is an elite corps of... corps? I think it should be C-O-R-P instead of C-O-R-E. But who knows? Especially trained soldiers. I see, okay. I mean, these guys were tough as well. These guys are pretty tough. They were pretty good shots. And usually, while the game has this thing where if you get shot once, if it's not in the head, it'll just give you, you know, a warning that your screen will turn red that you've been shot once. That did not happen this time around. No matter where you were shot, even if it was like on the vest, you would die in this mission. So anyway, they will not give up unless their leader is eliminated. What? Oh, yeah, that makes sense. I read that as they will not give up until the leader is eliminated. I was wondering why they want to eliminate their own leader. But yeah, anyway, moving on. That was it for Juggernaut, I do believe, yes. That was a short mission. At the same time, it was also a difficult mission because I didn't expect it to be this difficult. Next up, we will be completing Operation Condor. And after that, of course, only Diamondback is left. However, I do believe that is not the final mission of this campaign. There might be one more mission left for us to complete. So anyway, we'll see about that when we cross that bridge. But the next time we meet, we will be covering Operation Condor. Until then, thank you for tuning in today. Take care. Farewell, fellow Earthlings.